Pierre Enyeré, it's a very long way up to that capsule. What's that journey like, that moment that you leave Earth for the last time and get ready for launch?
Well, the very first moment of the takeoff, when suddenly you feel the vibration of the engine which is starting, you know that at this time, what I had in my head personally is, now nobody's going to take my flight. I'm sure I'm going to space, and especially the first time, because before, maybe almost any moment, for medical reason, for meteorological reason, it's possible that you don't. And well, they are fully focused on the procedures. Remember that even if technology has considerably improved since the very first flight, which were mentioned before, there is always a risk, and therefore, no, you are not how to say, you are not afraid, you have no fear, but you are very much concentrated on what is going on, because it's something unique in your life and that you remember all your the rest of your life.
And just how risky is this mission compared, for example, to previous missions, missions that you yourself have taken part in?
Well, I was very confident in the Soyuz system because Soyuz was very reliable. There were 1,600 more Soyuz launched in space, and with a very small percentage of problems. The big problem was with the space shuttle. If you remember, there were 135 flights with the shuttle, and there were two major casualties. And therefore, today we can, with the evolution of the technology, we can say that the chance, I was saying chance of deficiency, but it's unlikely, no. I mean, all the system has been designed taking into account the lessons learned by the past, and especially concerning the escape system. At any moment, from the ground to the orbit, the crew can be separated from the rocket and go down normally to space. And this is very comfortable for the crew. Nevertheless, if it happen, it's very, you should be a sportsman, because it's something like an acceleration of 10G, especially in the very last moment. There were a flight where the crew, Russian crew, ejected at the end of the second stage. And at the moment where you have still a very vertical trajectory, which means that when the engine stops, you go back to Earth with a very deep trajectory. They endure more than 50G during 30 seconds. They almost vanish during. So therefore, the risk, it's not a risk of losing your life. It's more a problem of experiencing something which is very naughty indeed.
Very nauseating, I can only imagine. And actually, that was the reason that this launch was delayed yesterday, because the weather wasn't good enough in the eventuality of that having to happen.
Yeah, but the reason was to avoid this sort of problem. Yeah, and especially I think there were big wind in altitude, and in case effectively of a failure of the rocket, they would have to use parachute for as a safety way to go back to Earth, and parachutes with high winds, they are not friends together, and that's why effectively the flight has been delayed yesterday. One of the reasons, at least.
Now we're seeing some rather extraordinary pictures of the astronauts making their way to the capsule, the Dragon capsule at the top of the rocket there. Now this is all happening very early in the morning in Florida. What can you tell us about the timing of this mission? Why did it have to happen when it's happening?
Because the space mechanics is such that if you want to dock to the space station, you must program the launch exactly when the orbital plan of the station go over the launch location, launch pad location. And therefore, you have windows, very narrow windows to take off. The other aspect is now, in my time, it took 2 days to go back to the station after the launch. Now they go to the station with a 3 hours trip. For in some cases, And to do that, you need also to be sure that not only during the launch the orbital plane of the station go by the launch, but also that the station is not far, because if you are on the same plane but the station is on the other side of the Earth, it takes you a long way to go back to the station. That are the conditions which determine the precise time for takeoff.